allowing me to contribute to the supplementary budget brought by the esteemed Minister of Finance on the 1st of August 2019. A very significant date in the country's history. Honorable Speaker, said, the country is living under the wings of crippling multiple challenges. That includes the challenge of macroeconomic instability. That includes interest rates that are so high, but still below the rate of inflation. Challenges that include the retail, the ugly retail of hyperinflation. Inflation now, as I'm talking to you, Honorable Speaker, stands around 560%. Challenges, Honorable Speaker, that include crippling power shortages, shortages of that are lasting 18 hours a day. In some cases, 24-hour power shortages, something that is unprecedented in the hundreds or so history of modern Zimbabwe from 1888. The majority of our people, Honorable Speaker, are vulnerable in poverty. 79% of our people are living below the poverty that I'm lying, surviving on less than US 35 cents. Honorable Speaker, the supplementary budget, therefore, is an obligation to provide a compass, to provide a leadership, to provide direction in the face of the existence of this multiple challenge. And I want to say, Honorable Speaker, that one of the key challenges that is now facing Zimbabwe more than ever is the challenge of corruption. Corruption has become so accentuated. Corruption has become so accelerated. Billions and billions of dollars, Honorable Speaker, are being lost. Unlike in the past, where the chief infrastructures of corruption were found in the private sector, in multinational corporations, in illicit financial flows. The recent character and the recent face of corruption is corruption that is taking place through central government itself, the Honorable Speakers. Corruption that is being channeled through the Ministry of Finance itself, the Honorable Speakers. And this is a huge challenge. That is the affecting our country. Now, when you measure, Honorable Speaker the supplementary budget that was laid out by the esteemed Minister of Finance on the 1st of August 2019, vis-a-vis these challenges, with great respect, you find the budget falling short, being dwarfed, not being equal to the challenges that we are facing. Not only that, Honorable Speaker, the budget itself is a big fraud. It's an entire statement of misrepresentation of the true state of the economic affairs of our country. And I start, Honorable Speaker, by the claim that we are increasing the budget by 10 billion Zimbabwe dollars. In fact, the budget speaks of anticipated revenue of $14 billion. It speaks of anticipated expenditure of $18 billion Zimbabwe dollars. Many of us will sit here and think that we are actually increasing the budget. I actually submit, Honorable Speaker, that we are actually contracting the budget. Our budget in 2019 that we approved in this August House on the 21st of December 2019 in the early hours was a budget expressed in US dollars, $6 billion in US dollars. Now, when you now approve a budget that is now 14 billion Zimbabwe dollars, and when the black market rate is 1:10, it means you have reduced $6 billion US dollars to $1.4 billion. So we are in fact serious the cake, Honorable Speaker. which is regulated, and it brings me to another fundamental thing that is in this budget. When you pronounce a budget, you are providing economic indicators for planners. And one of the key figures you must give is the figure for GDP, is the figure for growth rates. This is the first budget in the history of budgets that actually skirts the issue of GDP growth rate. I want to refer, Honorable Speaker, to paragraph 68, page 25 of the budget statement. And on that point, Honorable Speaker, I also want to place on record our complaint that when the budget statement was read out on the 1st of August 2019, it was not made available to members. It was not made available on the 2nd of February, so August 2019. And we were only given this budget a few minutes ago in this August chamber. The practice, Honorable Speaker, is that once it's laid before the table, it must be available in our pigeon rooms or at least in the papers office in the first floor. It was not available. That's not good governance, and that's not good hygiene. But I want to refer, Honorable Speaker, to paragraph 68. It says, in view of the headwinds, the revised 2019 GDP growth rate is expected to be negative, and even below the -2% projected under the S&P. Said that would therefore keep seeking key development in the economy with a view of making appropriate adjustments to sectorial growth policy. Honorable Speaker said, it is not good enough to say it will be below -2%. This statement must define the figure. What is the figure of the growth rate for 2019? Because every planner wants it. And the reason why the esteemed minister did not pin this figure, Honorable Speaker, because it is frightening. In its April regional economic outlook, the IMF projected that our growth rate in 2019 will be -5.5%, Honorable Speaker. I would like to submit with great respect that our growth rate will be at least -8.5% due to a number of issues, including the cyclone Idai, including the crippling drought that has affected our country when it is in fact an agricultural-based economy. So you cannot produce and present a media statement, Honorable Speaker, without the growth rate, without also the growth rate of the year, half year ending January to June 2019. If you are not going to present the growth rate for the half year ending, there's actually no point in coming to this August house, because the growth rate and the fundamental. Another myth, Honorable Speaker said, is the myth, the much hyped myth about the surplus. The minister speaks of a surplus of 800 million. Honorable Speaker said, with great respect, it is a misnomer, an error, a wrong, an omission to speak of a surplus and to boast of a surplus when you are using cash account in the context of expenses and expenditure that accrues. So unless we graduate to accrual accounting, it is not possible in the middle of the year or in the quarter of the year to speak about a surplus when you are using the cash account. Also, Honorable Speaker, when you are replacing allocations and investments to ministries, and ministries are starving, there are no drugs in hospitals, there are no textbooks in schools, and there is massive deficits in virtually every ministry, you can't boast of a surplus when you have kept the tap closed and you are not distributing even the statutory allocations that you pronounced in your budget. But more importantly, Honorable Speaker, we know that the surplus is a myth, because the supplementary budget itself provides for anticipated revenue of $14 billion, so Zimbabwe dollars, and expenditure of $18 billion. So the budget itself is budgeting for a deficit of $4 billion, which is at least 4% of the total budget. So there is in fact no surplus to talk about. But I want to go, Honorable Speaker, even to expenditure. You will see that in the half year ending June 2018, the total expenditure was $4.2 billion. But if you go to the original budget, as of June 2018, so 2019, the actual expenditure should have been 3.8. So the minister who is talking about a surplus and the austerity, in fact, exceeded his expenditure limit by at least 15%, being the difference between $3.8 billion and $4.2 billion. So it's a smokescreen budget, manipulated in this language, but obfuscating and hiding the serious flaws in the budget, certainly there's a technical document, but more importantly, hiding the flaws, the structural flaws that are affecting our economy. So, well, the technology will come. I want to speak about one of the speakers. Issue I want to speak about, which is very disconcerting, is the devaluation, the unlawful and unconstitutional devaluation that the minister has impacted on this economy. You know, Honorable Speaker, that in the last 5 years, this economy has been sustained by treasury bills. These treasury bills were issued in US dollar currency. These treasury bills are therefore US dollar paper. They constitute the bulk of our country's domestic debt. In one sweep, Honorable Speaker, the minister has converted the 9 billion US dollars treasury bills to 9 billion Zimbabwe dollars. Honorable Speaker, this is a breach of Section 71 of the Constitution of Zimbabwe. Section 71 protects the right to property. Section 71 protects the right against the appropriation. And I want to make reference in particular, Honorable Speaker, to paragraph 34, page 14 of the budget statement, where the minister writes as follows. The official writes as follows. Consequently, page 14, paragraph 34. It says, consequently, adherence to sound fiscal and monetary policy reforms allowed containment of domestic debt stock, which stood at Zimbabwean dollar 8.8 billion as at the end of June 2019, down from 9.5 billion as at 31st December 2018. The treasury bills, Honorable Speaker, were never indexed in Zimbabwean dollar. The Zimbabwean dollar did not exist until the 20th of February 2019, when the Statutory Instrument 33 of 2019 was enacted. So you cannot devalue the entire stock of domestic debt and suddenly index it in Zimbabwean dollar. It is illegal, it is unconstitutional, and it will have serious ramifications on the economy. Another myth, Honorable Speaker, is the myth by the minister contained at page 15, paragraph 37 to 41 of the budget statement. The minister states, as he boasts, the current account, for the first time since the adoption of the multi-currency regime in 2009, registered a surplus in the first quarter of 2019. A surplus of $196 million was registered in the first quarter of 2019 compared to a deficit of $491 million. Now, Honorable Speaker, it's not possible to talk of a current account surplus in Zimbabwe, when our GDP is shrunk by more than minus 8%. it's not possible to talk of a current account surplus when the economy is not producing. When you go to every supermarket in the Zimbabwe, whether it's a TM, whether it's Mikro's, whether it's OK Bazaars, whether it's Pick and Pay, 60 to 80% of the goods are imported. It's not possible, Honorable Speaker, to speak of a current account surplus when we spend over $1.5 billion of real money importing fuel, when we require at least $40 million per month to import electricity. So you cannot speak of a time surplus created by demand suppression methods and difficulties in getting foreign currency, and you boast of foreign currency. I want to say to the Honourable Minister of Finance, don't be concerned about lipstick and mascara and foundation. Don't be concerned about figures. Let the economy itself speak truthfully. What is the proper GDP? Another lipstick issue, Honourable Speaker. It is unprecedented in the history of economics. And I'm not an economist, just a poor lawyer. But it's unprecedented in the history of economics that a minister of finance, a well-educated professor, can suppress inflation figures. One of those. It, the paragraph, let me just find it quickly. The paragraph, one of the speakers. It is